everybody. Welcome back to Northern Lions Challenge Runs in the Binding of Isaac. We have a very interesting run today from YouTube user Completionist. By the way, in case you're not familiar, Mr. Completionist, you have a fantastic YouTube username, and if you ever wanted to start a YouTube channel, I think that is a good place to start from a marketing standpoint. It's not like youtube.com/buttfuckerxx69codmodernwarfare2, something that's going to be totally outdated and crazy. YouTube.com/completionist. That's a nice little buzzword there. Anyway, we got Isaac here. We got Guppy's Tail. We've got infinite keys. So obviously, we are going to be looking to open as many golden chests as possible here. And beyond that, no item rooms are allowed. So basically, we're going to be able to go to shops and boss rooms and things like that. But the main compensation, the balancing act for the fact that we have no, or we have so many keys, is the fact that we're going to be absolutely incapable. Or so many keys and access to golden chests, I should say, is that we're going to be absolutely incapable of going to the item rooms. I don't have unlimited keys. I just gave myself a skeleton key instead, which I figured would work. Don't worry, I'm not going to pick those items up. I was just checking to see what we were missing there in the item rooms, because I might as well, considering I have the skeleton key, and I might as well do some exploring anyway. So the D6 is still going to be available for use on boss rooms. I can still pick up whatever I want from Deal with the Devil rooms. Yes, whatever I want from Deal with the Devil rooms. You know what that means, but we'll see what we get as we come to it. I'm excited for this run. It's a very simple run, and that means to me that it has the potential to be a very elegant run as well, which are some of the ones that I like the most. I mean, here we go, Guppy's Tail. Well, not too much there. There's something to be said for those runs that are like, hey, Northern Lion, I gave you 80 items, and we're gonna see how crazy this shit can get. But there's also something that can be said for, hey, here's like a few items and some conditions that are diametrically opposed. Let's see if you can make something work with those. I like those runs too. I like them both. I'm a little lazy this morning, so I wanted to do a run that was a little bit less cheat engine intensive, because sometimes that program can be kind of a pain in the dick to work with. Okay, well, hopefully these are good pills, because we got two of them. Oh, that's not good. Obviously, we're not going to take both of those, because that would be pretty gosh darn silly. By the way, I have to note, probably the most suggested condition for a run that I get is, like, something plus max speed down, like basically not being able to move. I probably get like 4 or 5 suggestions for runs like that every day. It's unlikely that it's gonna happen. I mean, I appreciate the creativity. A lot of them are like mom's knife, no range, no speed. So you basically just have to walk into everything. Some of them are mom's knife, no range, max speed. But anyway, those no speed runs are not gonna happen just because I find it so goddamn annoying to not be able to move very quickly. I mean, I don't mind moving at this speed. It's a little slow, but it's not the end of the world. What I do mind is those runs where I basically just have nothing. Like, it takes me four or five seconds to just get across a room, as opposed to 1 or 2 seconds. So those runs are unlikely to happen, unless my opinion on that changes a great deal in the near future, which I think is unlikely. But again, thank you for your continued creativity and suggestions. Just don't expect those runs that are, like, truly torturous to appear. And you know, a lot of people, a lot of viewers have mentioned that they don't want to see super speed down runs either, because oftentimes those runs are kind of annoying to watch. So what I'm doing here, you might be thinking, Northern Lion, why not just go to the boss room? There's no need to search out like a second item room or anything. Well, you're right about that, but I do want to search as much as possible to see if perhaps I could find myself a little bit of extra money to go to the shop, because basically the shop is the only way that we are going to be able to pick up items here, apart from bosses, of course. And if I can get some good items in the shop, who knows, maybe we could turn this run around a little bit. Not that it's going badly so far, but we're worse than base Isaac, in the sense that we now have just base Isaac plus speed down. That was awful damage to take. And we're not getting a whole lot of red hearts, which is unfortunate. If only that pill had been like a health up at the start, that would have been beautiful. It would have paid for a mom's knife, spirit of the night, brimstone upgrade, basically. So here's our shop. The problem is, there's so many possible locations for a secret room as well, but with 99 keys, we might as well at least go in. And we're gonna get a little bit of extra money here, as well as a little bit of extra health. So, Guppy's Tail doing something for us. No need to buy another key, I would say. I would love to buy the coin purse, but I think there's only like 3 or 4 locations for a secret room. Maybe we'll get lucky enough, we'll be able to buy the coin purse. So let's just see what we're missing from our boss room here. Or sorry, from our item room here. That would have been Rage without a reroll, and Rage is one of my favorite items, so this one hurts a little bit to pass up. Oh well, that's the name of the game, basically. Avira Antivirus, what's wrong here, buddy? Auto run blocked for your security. How about, for my convenience, you turn off, which is what I'm gonna do right now. Thank you very much. Can't you see? I'm trying to work right now. We're up to 9 cents. So we have 5 bombs. We're gonna look for the secret room, which undoubtedly will contain a slot machine because the troll engine hates me lately. Well, that's not even... First off, it's gonna take us 10 minutes to find it. There's no question about that. Then, I'm expecting all slot machines. Maybe like 4 or 5 slot machines. Why not? By the way, we will be able to get an extra 2 cents in here. We will have to deal with this fire, though. And that is indeed the secret room, so that's lucky for us. Alright, so we're up to 11 cents. That's exactly what I figured would happen. We're now up to 14. Thanks for the red heart, though. And we'll do a little bit more exploration to see if we can't get up to that 15th cent. But we might just want to save our money, or potentially reroll whatever we could get on the, whatever we get in the shop. I don't know. Here's what I'm thinking, step one. Let's go to the blood bank first. We're up to 15 cents now. We'll see if we want to use these rerolls on any of these bosses, because it does potentially give me the deal with the devil option on this floor, provided that I don't lose too much health. And we can always save this money and use it in the shop on the next floor, because, I mean, Mom's coin purse is not that great of an item. It could potentially be good. It could potentially be terrible. Oftentimes, it ends up kind of hovering around like a neutral zero mark, really. So we're just going to hang out around here, take out this guy. Hope that Pin largely does a lot of damage to himself, because otherwise, with base damage, this could be a fairly long fight here. But a fairly easy fight nonetheless. That's not going to hit him. You just, whenever he pops up, you got to stand reasonably close to him. And then he'll shoot it near himself. Yeah, that did a lot of damage. So Pin will be dead soon. I am hoping for a HP upgrade, I guess. I like getting HP upgrades early, because it gives you a little bit of security in case something goes horribly wrong. Speed upgrade's not bad. Let's go, again, we're gonna go check out our second boss first. And then I can always go back in there and reroll that speed upgrade if this guy gives me something good. But I might just want to take the D6, sorry, take the speed upgrade to compensate for that speed down I got earlier. One speed down is not necessarily the end of the world, but it would be nice to be back at normal speed for sure. So we're just gonna let the Widow basically do most of the damage to his own underlings here. And we're just gonna move side to side. He should be able to jump on his own nub there. Possibly. Never mind. He is dead though. More extra health for us, which is good. We can use that at the blood bank if we need to. And I think I'm just gonna abandon the shop on this floor. I think I'm gonna say, you know, coin purse probably isn't worth it right now. Hopefully it doesn't come back to bite me in the ass. We're gonna take the HP upgrade. We're gonna reroll the speed upgrade and get a tears upgrade. Okay, I feel okay about that decision. And then we're gonna head down to the next floor. Hopefully, to buy something a little bit better than the coin purse. So we're firing faster now. Oh! That was close. We're firing faster now. Still moving a little bit slowly, but that's okay. And we are on Catacombs Part 1. Oh, this is not good. I hate these rooms. We almost made it out of there, believe it or not. And again, we're gonna be hoping for, you know, I mean, this is the point in the game where, since the first floor wasn't great to us, I just want HP upgrades. I really do not want to fight a pestilence on this floor and end up getting 1 cube of meat and never doing anything with it. So I think the smart money here is on buying the 9 volt. It'll make our D6 charge a little bit faster, but mostly we're just future-proofing our run against whatever might come next. So if we get another spacebar item again in the near future, this will allow it to charge a little bit faster. Obviously then we'll get more usefulness out of it, and a more useful spacebar item is a big predictor of success in this game. I feel like I keep messing up my speech. I had like 5 coffees yesterday. It's quite early in the morning on the day following yesterday, which, you know, in English we call that today, in case you didn't know. What can I say? Former English teacher, it's my duty to educate. But yeah, I've had like 0 today and it feels like my brain is totally busted. On the bright side, I mean, it's weird to be saying this because this video is going to go up like 3 or 4 days, if not more, after this was recorded. But hey, our Wii U finally arrived today. It took 100 years, basically. But it finally got here. I always feel bad. Like, the Wii U was sent through a company that I believe is Canadian. Like, EB ships through a Canadian shipping company called Perlator. And it took so long to get here. And it might not have been Perlator's fault. It might have been EB's fault for not shipping it or processing it on time or whatever. But, judgment. Okay. I'm gonna take this pill first, see what happens. Okay. That's not bad. See what our item room would have been if we could go to it. Would have been, we've gotten some good item rooms there. That would have been Brother Bobby. But anyway, I thought I was being clever. I made a tweet and it was like, I guess they call it Pearl Later because you get your shit later than you want it. And then like this corporate Twitter account for Perlator was like, I'm very sorry that you had to deal with this. Is there anything I can do to verify the status of your shipment? And I was like, oh, Kathy, I'm sorry. I was just kind of being a dick to impress my friends in social media. I don't feel good about this now. Then again, it might have been Perlator's fault, so who knows. But anyway, the Wii U is here. Sadly, our shipment of Zombie U still has not arrived. That actually is Perlator's fault, so maybe I should stop feeling bad. And we're gonna go out and buy a bunch of Wii U games tonight. Basically, all the games we can find. I don't give a shit if it's only Funky Barn everywhere. I will be buying some Funky Barn and playing some Funky Barn. Because, you know, Nintendo Land's cool and everything, but you need to get a feel for how the system works in general. So expect some Wii U videos coming very soon. Very, very soon, in fact. In fact, they'll probably be up by the time you're watching this video, maybe several days earlier, so just pretend that I'm not talking to you from the past slash future, and everything will be okay here. So let's see what we've got in our Catacombs boss fight. It's gonna be Peep. Kind of a rough draw, but hopefully... Oh, I mean, obviously there's two things I want out of this boss fight right here. One of them is an HP upgrade from Peep, and the other one is a deal with the devil from Satan. Now, I kind of want Peep to jump because I'm worried about him getting stuck behind these rocks here. That's okay, we're alright. Peep's about a quarter of the way done, I would say. And he's super far away now. Now he's becoming more of a pain in the ass. I want him to jump less now. But we're just gonna keep staying away from the eye. And once that second eye comes out, it's gonna be a little bit more difficult for me to deal with, because my brain can't parse like that, apparently. I don't know what it is with Peep, man. That eye movement always gets me every single time. It's just like... my brain is not built to handle diagonals. The same thing happens when I fight that, like, the husk boss. Or whatever boss it is that, it's like the two Larry Juniors that go diagonally. I've totally forgotten that now. Should probably know that considering this is episode, what, like 300,000? Come on here, Peep. Work with me. I almost got hit by the creep there. The Peep creep is deeply creepy. It doesn't really work. That was a lazy rhyme. I don't appreciate that. Still dodging well here. I think yellow Peep's shots might be a little slower than your average Peep. And beyond that, I think the yellow Peep is actually a little bit stronger in terms of HP, maybe. I did get hit for the first time there. Oh, almost got hit for the second time there. Come on, Peep has like 10 shots or less left in him. Well, there's the second time by way of that eye, because I'm an idiot. There's the third time by way of Peep. And there's the fourth time. Wow, there goes my deal with the devil opportunity. But hey, really good item. In meat here, we're gonna get a little HP upgrade, a little damage, and a little tears as well. Down to the next floor. Does this run have the potential for success? I think so. We still need more of everything, basically. Health, damage, speed would not hurt, certainly. But yeah, lots of potentiality here at the very least. I could use some more health. Now the interesting thing is I have this judgment, but I don't necessarily want to use judgment yet because I want to save my money and use it at shops, and then use my money that I get after the womb, or I should say after the depths, because there's gonna be no shops after the depths part 2. Use that to spend on this judgment. So just take these guys out one by one, not moving around too much, because that makes dodging a little bit easier. That might sound crazy. Here we go. Guppy's tail has not affected us too much so far. It hasn't really given us all that many golden chests, but that's okay. Still digging this run. We have the potentiality for a ladder here, which is not that interesting to me. But it could be useful. I mean, ladder's one of those items, if we have the money, we might as well buy it, because it almost always pays for itself. But for now, I'm thinking bigger. I need bigger items. I want Game Kit, I want Relic, Nail, well, I'm thinking Spacebar items specifically. Nail, Book of Revelations, anything that gives us Spirit Hearts and allows us to survive a little bit better. More money, that's good too. We should look for secret rooms. We have enough bombs now to make it probably worthwhile. That's not one. We have an arcade, which raises an interesting predicament. I mean, we could go play that arcade and potentially get a blood bag there, which would be very useful for us. Again, HP is kind of at a premium right now, especially since I am wanting in the future to pick up some kind of deal with the devil. I mean, you know what three I'm going to mention. Spirit of the Night, Brimstone, Mom's Knife, or my holy trinity of deal with the devil items. But, you know, I'm not necessarily picky when it comes to that stuff. I could take other ones. If necessary, at the very least. Keep in mind that with Guppy's Tail, two Guppy items... oh, come on. Yeah, two Guppy items would turn us into a cat, which is a huge predictor of success. Like, if you get the cat, you can fly, you create flies. Whenever you get hit, whenever you hit in, like, every room. If you have Guppy's head, anyway. It's an interesting possible situation to be in. Now, I got hit a lot on greed here, so that's gonna cost me some money, but by using some bombs, I can get a lot of that money back, too. Red chest is 2 bombs. I was hoping one of these maybe would get this nickel up here, but no. So I'm really worried about health at this point. Really need some red HP upgrades, I would say. Well, not HP upgrades, just HP in general. But hearts, again, apparently seem to be a little bit hard to come by, unfortunately. Maybe, if I play Judgment, he'll feel a little bit more generous. So we've got money equals power in there. That's a decent item. So Judgment, come on, hook me up here, buddy. HP upgrade and red hearts out the ass, please. Just don't milk me for 12 cents and get... There we go, we got an HP upgrade out of him. That's worth it. We're still gonna look for the secret room. Because again, I could maybe re-roll the ladder or I could take the ladder. That's not the secret room. This might be the secret room. Okay, what do we have in here? 3 more cents. Not quite enough. Maybe if we shoot this fire, we'll get incredibly lucky. If I didn't get hit so much on greed, I would have made it. But hey, you know what? We can always save our money right now and go to the shop on the later floor. And just hope for maybe another HP upgrade. Great deal with the devil here. And I should have looked at the name! What was I thinking? Okay, so we're just backing off like crazy here. Like I said, for some reason, this boss seems to be incompatible with my way of thinking. Luckily, these guys are like in sync. Just keep going in exactly the same direction, exactly the same pattern. Now they are a little bit out of sync, which I don't appreciate as much. That's okay. Just gonna keep this up, backing up and around. The closer these guys get to each other and the further away they get from me, the happier I am. If I could just get one of them killed, there we go. I feel like I could dodge the other one with relative ease. What is this thing? I feel like I'm playing a Tremors video game. The crate! We're gonna reroll it. Range up. I feel like an idiot. The crate would have been better for the Spirit Heart alone. But oh well. The range upgrade's fine too. Gives us a little bit of... Oh, finally we have a gosh darned tinted rock. Sorry, apologies for the strong language there. Now, we're gonna break open all this stuff right here. I started my Scribblenauts series yesterday on YouTube, and I was trying to think of ways to market it. And I always hear a YouTube marketing tip is like, try to get your series approved as shows, because the shows have a search ranking priority anyway. I'm not gonna bore you with any details like that. But then I said it as a show, and it was like, what kind of, like, parental guidance rating do you want to give your show? And I was like, well, it does have strong language, so I clicked on strong language. I mean, I didn't know that it had strong language, but I'm just like, I don't monitor my language, so I probably was swearing or something. And then it put up like a parental guidance before the video and was like, warning, this video has strong language, do you wish to proceed? And I was like, oh man, that's really stupid. One of my biggest pet peeves is when, like, Let's Players think that they're on TV or like they're bigger than they are or something. So they're like, a warning to all the parents out there watching this right now, this video has strong language, so you might want to take the kiddies away. And I'm like, dude, like 10 people watch you maximum. I think they're smart enough to figure it out. And I felt like those guys briefly. Oh, this is not good. This is very not good. I'm running so low on health. Nikajowaka, Isaac Solo. Okay, now we're really playing with fire here. And I got killed! Wow, that is abysmal. I really don't know what to say about that. This has been a bad run so far. Let's replay it, I guess. It's been 20 minutes. Let's give it another try, though. And we'll hopefully get a little bit better luck this time. That was an awful play on my part. But also, man, I was getting some pretty not great items. At least, because I was doing so badly, I expected a deal with the angel to show up at the very least at some point. Oh god, cheat engine is not activated. What do we have in our item room? Holy water. Well, good thing we're not using that anyway. So let's go down here and check this out. Add item when entering next room. We want to go all the way down here, and Guppy's tail exists somewhere in here. It's Guppy's head. There's Guppy's tail, so we'll click on that. Drag it in here. Again, thank you to Completionist for this run. I can't stress enough. You have a great marketing advantage over most people if you want to start a YouTube channel. What are we looking for here now? I was looking for Skeleton Key. Yeah, man. YouTube.com/completionist. That you could make like a great show about that. Where is... Oh, it's down here. I remember it was below these ones, or above these ones, I guess, technically. But below those ones, I think. Skeleton Key. Really? I always do this. I think it was before the Steam sale. What is wrong with me here? Okay, we'll go all the way back down here. I just didn't think it was before meat and stuff like that. Those are like the first items I always think of. Oh, maybe it is. Okay. So we're gonna go with Skeleton Key here. Oh, not add address manually. I have no idea what that means. There's Skeleton Key. Let's turn off Cheat Engine now. Very bad play for me so far, but that's why I'm doing a second run here. Oh, hello, Audacity. That's why I'm doing a second run here to sort of figure things out a little bit more. So we're probably just gonna go directly to the boss room here. There's nothing really keeping us here except the potentiality of finding a... Did I not go for the Tinted Rock on the last episode, or last run? That would have been stupid if I didn't. Anyway, except for the potentiality of finding that secret room, but for now, let's speed things up a little bit. Sometimes when you play with some urgency, you do a little bit better. Also, I feel like my dodging's gonna be a little bit better now because I actually, I'm familiar with this base speed, shall we say. Being at a speed disadvantage was not necessarily a huge problem, but being a little bit slower, sometimes even just a slight change to your speed can affect your, you know, the patterns that you're used to, the muscle memory that you become accustomed to. So we're gonna kill Monstro here fairly easily. Like I say many times, we have fought Monstro probably, you know, somewhere in the vicinity of like 100 times. Maybe more when you count like boss trap rooms and the fact that he spawns on the Mom's Heart boss fight. So maybe like 200 times, we're definitely rerolling the shit out of that. And we get HP upgrade, awesome! This is a much better start than the last one. I wonder what boss we fought the most. I mean, you might think that it's Mom or Mom's Heart. Well, I guess Mom would be automatically better than, or more frequent than Mom's Heart, assuming we'd ever lost against Mom's, before Mom's Heart. But I don't think it is. I think it's one of the bosses that you fight on the first floors, just to compensate for all those runs where I've died before Mom's Heart. Boss I've fought the most? I would almost say Larry Jr., maybe? I mean, but the thing is, it depends on what you classify as a boss, right? Because you fight Monstro in rooms oftentimes, just randomly. I guess you fight Larry Jr. in random rooms sometimes, too. But you always fight a Monstro and a Chub on the Mom's Heart boss fight, unless you beat it unbelievably quickly. Oh man, that's awesome! Finally! This run has paid off for us a little bit. We got Steven, gonna give us a little bit of a damage upgrade, which is beautiful. We got Super Gluttony, which is pretty surprising to be running into a difficult enemy like this so early on. Well, I guess he's not difficult, but this is great because Super Gluttony, that was awful dodging, has the potential to give us HP upgrade, which would be beautiful. It also give us, I believe he gives us the heart, which would also give us, oh my god, that dodging, man. Would also give us a little bit of health and compensation in addition to that, which would be great. Well, instead he gave us an eternal heart. I want to pick up that Eternal Heart, but we're going to save it for now, and I'm going to pick it up slow. Wait, that's Christina Milian. We're going to pick it up after we get a Spirit Heart, hopefully. Or after we beat everything else on the floor, we can just walk back and basically get a free HP upgrade for it. So why not? Picking it up right now would just be a waste. I've done it before many, many times, and I regret it each time. Okay, I'm surprised we managed to kill those spiders before they got to us. Oh! Every single time, man. I hate these spiders in the corner. Let's just see what our item room would have been. Kamikaze, or sorry, that's Remote Detonator. Not a big deal to be passing that up. And we're going to be dealing with Pin again. We're going to be doing more damage this time, and hopefully Pin will do more damage to himself as well. Because last time, he was fairly prudent with his bombs. He only hit himself once, maybe twice. So hopefully things work out a little bit better this time. Normally, 18 minutes into a video, it's rare for me to do a restart, however, I felt like that was such lackluster play that I owed you guys a little bit more in today's video. And that's fine with me. My coffee can wait a little bit longer. As can the Wii U, which apparently, I've heard, the Wii U has a mandatory system update. We're gonna reroll this. Yes, okay. Wii U has a mandatory system update that takes like an hour. And if you, like, turn off your console during the system update, it can, like, brick it. Like, straight up destroy the console. Which strikes me as fucking insane. But, you know, that's why I'm not just running that update in the background right now. That's why I want to be there. And be like, if anybody touches this shit, I am gonna wreck their face. Not that it seems like Wii U's are particularly rare right now. The reason I've pre-ordered one online is because, like, I want to make sure I have one as soon as it comes out. Well, thanks a lot, Perlator slash EB, maybe. But, yes. I would love to get the blue candle. Unfortunately, there's no way in hell we can afford it. But yeah, it turns out I could have just gone to, like, Walmart or Future Shop or EB, in fact, and just bought one myself, which would have been way easier, but hey. Ended up getting here alright, so that's cool. A few days late, but, you know, in the whole lifespan of a console, which tends to be, at this point, I guess, like, 7 years, 5 years, maybe at the bare minimum for the Wii. Although the Wii came out 2006, so I guess it is 6 years. Anyway, yeah, in the whole scheme of things, one extra half week is not a big deal with respect to waiting. So we're gonna see what we got here. Maybe enough money to finally use the shop on this floor, which would probably allow us to maybe pick up a better item. I mean, blue candle is not gonna show up in shops again, which is unfortunate, because with the current setup of items that we have, it would be the definite most, like, synergistic upgrade that we could possibly get. Unfortunately, you know, you can't always get what you want, which has become the new de facto catchphrase over... I didn't pick up the Eternal Heart. Oh my god! I started to talk about the Wii U, and then I just it faded away from memory, unfortunately. Well, we got an HP upgrade anyway. Still, that is very, very silly of me. That's why I need someone beside me at all times. I need a live stream so people can be like, Northern Lion, the Eternal Heart! Oh well. Again, that sort of stuff is gonna happen if we succeed anyway. Well, then it didn't really matter. And if we fail anyway, well, one heart probably wouldn't have made the difference. Unless it would have. And then I take back everything that I've said so far. So, we're gonna check here for the secret room. Again, money very important to us because we can't go to item rooms. So we might as well get as much coinage as possible. But also, I'm banking on these deals with the devil, and they just haven't been showing up. Neither have Tinted Rocks, really. I mean, this is only the second Tinted Rock I remember seeing. It's totally possible, you know, I've been watching Vintage Isaac too. It's totally possible that I've missed it just in my own stupidity or lack of awareness. We got a tarot card out of the golden chest. What have we learned from this run so far? I think we've learned that golden chests are not adequate compensation for not being able to go to item rooms. The sound you just heard is like 50,000 commenters just being like, duh. Okay, so there's our secret room, there's our shop. And we can see everything else as well. Usually I like to save those world cards for a little bit later, but whatever. Again, not a big deal. I'm taking so much damage against, like, enemies that I really should not be taking damage against. We got a pill, we got a ladder. We're probably gonna reroll the ladder. The pill is speed down. All right, this is becoming a trend that I'm not a huge fan of. Why don't we reroll the ladder now? Let me get the map instead. Slightly better, actually. The map is something that I would love to pick up on this run. Because, of course, being able to find the secret room on every floor without wasting a bunch of bombs is pretty important to us from a financial perspective. So we have the Fool. We have 3 cents, which is going to give us 1 cent too little to buy what we need to buy. But, I don't know. Alas and alack, we're going to continue onwards here. Can we beat the Caves Part 1 this time? I think we beat Caves Part 1 last time. We died at, like, Necropolis. Against Greed. Ah, I hate when Greed ends a run, man. So we're getting bombs and keys again. We don't have any money. That's the real problem. The miter would be a beautiful item for us to get, but... you know, if you're looking for somebody to blame, blame Completionist, man. And his sexy-sounding YouTube marketing name. Oh, just give me a single penny, please. So I can make this work a little bit better for myself. Alright, Gertie. Like, the one time in my life that maybe I want Pageant Boy, although it's probably still not really. I would much rather have an HP upgrade Mom's Knife, but oh well. We're gonna pop the Magician card here. Just because I kinda want it out of my inventory slot, if nothing else. Beyond that, maybe it'll help me get an extra hit or two on this fight. I doubt it. But you never know. Stranger things have happened, I suppose. Probably, in the history of mankind. So we're just gonna keep going on like this. I remember when Gertie was such a difficult boss for me. Those were the days, man. Man, I really hope we don't get Gertie on the Caves Part 1. I mean, those are back in the days when I guess I didn't really know what great items were all the time. So I was oftentimes in a situation where my damage was quite poor. And you know, my damage is pretty poor right now, which is unfortunate because we have gotten the damage upgrade. We really need to get some kind of extra damage booster right now. I wonder if I turned off Deals with the Devil and Cheat Engine, or I'm just playing so bad that I'm not being rewarded with Deals with the Devil. In any case, Gertie is finally dead, so my idle brain can stop spinning its wheels with respect to that. And do we go? Oh my god, Tears upgrade, which will reroll to an HP upgrade and head down to the next floor. We're at 6 health at least, but I don't know how much longer I can survive with a run. This... like, I was gonna say boring, that's not really fair, but a run this basic. And that's no fault of the suggestion, either. Like, this is a decent idea for a run, but what we're finding, I think, is that... it's simply not good it's not adequate compensation, but hey, that's why they call it a challenge run. Is it not? No, seriously, is it not? I can't remember. We're gonna pick up all this stuff. Finally, we have enough money to buy something from the shop. And let me guess, it's gonna be something we absolutely do not want. A compass would be cool. I would love a compass. Mom's purse doesn't appeal to me in the least at this point. Because it's not like the Polaroid's gonna be giving me permanent invincibility. I have to pick it up anyway. And we're probably not gonna get any other trinkets. Oh, man. And Lucky Toe is not really that great of a trinket anyway. I don't mind missing it. We're gonna open our shop here, see what we got. It's the Hourglass. Certainly would have rerolled that one. And with 8 cents, I think it is, or sorry, 8 bombs, it's reasonable to be looking for the secret room here, of course. Sadly, we find nothing right off the bat there. Maybe up here, though. We got champion silkworms. So we're just gonna basically stand and deliver here from as far away as we can. More money, always welcomed. The worst possible item for us to get, I think, would be money equals power. I mean, it's not gonna be bad. But, in fact, it might even compensate for the fact that we would not buy items from the shop probably at that point. Because it would give us like 3 damage upgrades with 30 cents, which is pretty good. Oh well. The worst item for us to get would be like number 1. Like, vastly increased tiers but awful range would be potentially devastating for us right now. Let's bust open these guys. And our secret room could potentially be to the right here. Which would be great for me, because I don't want to do too much more backtracking. And also, I don't want to do any bomb wasting in preparation for this. Okay, good. We got more bombs. Maybe I can do some bomb wasting now. Let's toss this one over here. What do you got for me? Secret room. Excellent. 9 cents. Finally. So we do have probably at least 2 shops available. We have the potentiality for 3, but at least 2 is my expectation. I hate these rooms, but slowly and surely, doesn't slowly and surely sound like a great name for a sitcom or something? Or slowly but surely, but surely spelled like S-H-I-R-L-E-Y. More money, spirit hearts, finally these golden chests are paying off with abundance here. This is gonna be a tricky room. Didn't manage to get any shots in on this guy before he got to me, so that caused a serious problem. Well, not a serious problem, but we did take some damage. And we're gonna continue to take some damage, apparently. There we go. Finally. Got it done. So we do have our shop up here, of course. More money, always welcomed. I just wish we got this on the second or first floor. So that I would have actually been able to make use of that blue candle, which would solve me a lot of problems right now. Who knows, maybe it'll appear again, though. Fairly unlikely. I suppose stranger things have happened. I can't afford to just stand here, or I'll get hit on the next wave. So we're gonna back it up a little bit. Some of these guys are hurt, which is great for me. I think that one bomb fly only has 1 hit left, and this one might only have like, oh, only 1 itself. Alright, what do you got for me, shop? Greed. This is good. You heard me. Greed is good. If we can finish off this boss fight, get more money, maybe even get a steam sale or something, although with 40 cents, it's not that big of a deal. But if we get a steam sale, we can actually reroll it, which might be more valuable right now. Because again, with 48 cents, I'm going to be able to buy what I want from the shops anyway. Unless I get like 8 judgment cards, it's something that would probably end up paying out okay. I'm just gonna keep this up. This time greed is not gonna end 2 runs in a row, thank you very much. At least not yet. Super greed could still come in and ruin things a little bit. But that's okay. You are deceased, we got a steam sale which we will re-roll. Might seem silly because we got 2 shops left, but I assure you this is... without even doing any min-maxing. Battery. So we don't have the 9 volt this time. Instead what we've got is the battery. Which is fine, honestly. Functions pretty similarly. And if we can get a better spacebar item than the one that we currently have, I think we actually have found ourselves in a position where it might be possible for us to succeed. Maybe not likely, but certainly possible for us to succeed. So let's go down here to the boss room. Unfortunately, we will not have rerolls available for a boss room, angel room, or deal with the devil room. But we got the battery, so it's a fair compensation, I would say. Unfortunately, we are dealing with pestilence here, which is something I mentioned much earlier in the video, is something I didn't really want to do. Reason for that, largely, is that, you know, a single cube of meat does nothing for me in this situation. So I'm really hoping we get a deal with the devil after this, or a deal with the angel that gives us a great item. You know, relic, we've already seen the mitre. I don't even know if the relic can show up and deal with the angel runes, but obviously sacred tears, holy grail, any item like that would be beautiful in my estimation. So we're just gonna kill pestilence here fairly easily. Oh, we are gonna have D6 because of the battery. Nice, that could potentially come in handy if we get some kind of special room, which we don't. So let's move down to the next floor and pretend I ever mentioned anything. Alright, we're finally back to the depths. It's not Necropolis this time. And I feel a little bit stronger. Britney Spears style. Now we're just gonna stay on the left side here. Now we're gonna move, or I guess we're on the right side. Shooting to the left side, what I meant to say, of course. You think I would get my simple directions mixed up like that? Haha! Until I was like 9, I didn't know what left and right were. What can I was a true child of the wilderness. I just functioned entirely on latitudes and the polarity of the earth. We have portable slot machine. That's the easiest reroll I've ever seen in my whole life. Mom's purse might be the second easiest reroll. I know it seems crazy. Ryan, you always want mom's purse. Why aren't you taking mom's purse? I really want a good spacebar item, and this might be one of our last chances to get it. That's what I'm focusing on right now. If we can get that spacebar item up with the battery, especially even something like the Game Kit, which is a good item, but not a game-breaking item, would be awesome. And we should be able to get a lot of rerolls here because, we are working with the battery ourselves. So I want green face to shoot at these brain guys, but it seems to be having some aversion to that for some reason. We will use a bomb on this chest. I'm expecting a lot more resources of various types. We got keys and hearts and money and bombs and keys. Oh, D6 was available. I definitely should have used it right there. Oh well. Shit happens, you know? Keep this up. Hide in the corner. Bomb fly is a pain in the dick. That's okay, though. One more hit. I think he'll explode. Too bad I can't. There we go. Really thought he would get his friend in the blast radius there, but I guess not. Let's go back down to the shop here, and I think I've got a good feeling about this reroll. Maybe Book of Revelation, something that gives me a longer chance of survival. Compass. I'll take it. It's not the greatest item, but hopefully we get a shop on the next floor. And really, beyond that, it's just an item that allows me to basically, what was I going to say? Once we get to, later on in the game, it allows me to avoid a lot of damage, kind of passively. By just skipping rooms that would otherwise be incredibly damaging to me. It's kind of like the hyperwave relay in XCOM. You know where everything is, you know what, well, I guess you don't really know what every room contains, but you can just, you know, take the path necessary to get you to your destination, basically. I do think it's worth a bomb, because these red chests can potentially sometimes be okay. We get a halo of flies out of it that are gonna attack war. We're gonna get a second cube of meat, which makes the pestilence fight earlier not so bad, and we actually got some spirit hearts as well. Now, we've gotta be almost in the territory where we've earned a deal with the devil or an angel room, right? Like, those angel rooms usually come because you haven't gone to a deal with the devil room for a long time. Oh, come on. Certainly! We've got to be getting close to that. 5 floors without a deal with the devil. I'm starting to go into withdrawal here. Now remember, I did get a speed down earlier. This represents a legitimate problem for us. As, of course, war very much capable of chasing us down. I'm not sure what I'm going to do about that. Apart from basically just eat it. Seriously, war, buddy. You gotta work with me here. Oh my god. Who needs homing bombs when you got that sweet, like, brownie in motion there? Alright, this guy's gonna be fast. He's faster than us. But that's okay. We're still gonna survive. Yeah, there we go. Another hit. Can we survive without being hit once more? Come on, there we go. Okay. No deals! Seriously! That was what I was relying on for, like, this whole run. From the concept stage, from the second I heard about this run, I was like, okay, so we can make this work if we just pick up, like, a brimstone or mom's knife or something. Failing that, we'll get some kind of deal with the angel, you know? That'll work, too. Alright. Hopper, that was a rough situation there, but we made it out. Okay. So, chest contains bloody penny. sort of wish I got Mom's purse now, but the compass is more valuable. So, no biggie. That bomb's gonna be totally worthless. Now, we do have a little extra damage now by way of the cube of meat. However, it's not a lot. Well, okay, at least that bomb wasn't a total waste. It's not a lot of damage. But it is at least something that gives us a little bit more recourse against some of these more difficult enemies. I mean, we've been struggling heavily with respect to our bosses so far, so that's just something that maybe gives us a little, like, percentage increase that previously we did not have. These guys are doing some weird brownie in motion of their own. I left a brownie in motion in the toilet this morning. And then the motion was overturned. We're gonna see what we've got here. I kinda had a feeling this would happen. I refuse to let this run die at the hands of a Super Greed. Oh. He's a Super Greed! Super Greed! He's super greedy! Wow. Oh, okay. Not good so far. There's a heart. Thank you, Bloody Penny. I was thinking maybe, like, I could somehow replenish my health. Could I actually replenish my health on this fight? I think I could. It's like, every time I get hit, I drop 3 cents, and if two of those give me an actual heart via Bloody Penny, I would actually amass a little bit more health than I'd lost. But mostly, I just want this guy to die. And if we come across a secret room, we can get enough health to replenish us for sure. Come on, Sue. There we go. Thank you. Really? No hearts yet? Maybe this last one. And there's one there, too. Alright, so we ended up gaining some health on this fight. But the real kick in the ass is that I wish that Super Greed was not there in the first place. Because if we'd bought something else, who knows, maybe it would have given us that extra kick over the edge we needed. Because right now, we have basically no chance of success. I hate to be that guy, but we're not in a very good position at all here. Not doing very much damage, despite the fact that I know some people are like, you got Steven earlier, you're doing some damage. One damage upgrade does not a good run make. Again, if we were playing 2011 era Binding of Isaac, where all we had to do was beat Mom and Mom's heart, I'd be a little bit more, or a little bit less disheartened right now. However, we are not playing 2011, we're almost playing 2013 era Binding of Isaac here, where everything is a dick and nobody loves you. That's alright. So I really think if we'd gotten those item rooms, we'd obviously be in a much better position right now. But hey, that's why you do this, you learn, you look at this run on the outset, or in the concept phase, and you're like, yeah, this seems like a run that could be, you know, normal and actually work out potentially. Maybe it's like a 50-50 run, 40-60, who knows. Turns out, it's substantially, those Guppy's Tail golden chests don't show up all that often, and very rarely do they give you a game-breaking item. Or even a game-helping item, really. And Blue Mom is probably the one I would least want to fight right now because of these difficult enemies that are going to be sent out. Unfortunately, there's not a whole lot we can do about that apart from stand still and take it like a man. Luckily, Greed has possibly allowed us to get a lot of health back here. Well, one half red heart, thank you very much. Oh, and I walked right into it? Okay, now we've got problems. Like, legitimate serious problems. Thank you, Mom's foot. Now, we've got things in a manageable position here. Let's try to keep them that way. As long as, like, foot and nothing else is easy. I can roll with this all day, but I'm worried about whether or not that is going to be in the cards for us. There we go. Still going okay here. Really have to send out double spiders in this situation? This makes you seem like kind of a douche nozzle, Mom. Turn it back. Okay, we're good. We've been managing these enemies very well so far. I think we might make it out of this fight. Two double spiders, really? Three double spiders! Okay, now we're in no man's land here. One more hit and we're done. It's gonna come soon if it's coming. Greedhead. Asshole Larry Jr. lookalike. Single spider, much better. Oh, the spider got us! Well, again, thank you, completionist! Enjoy embarking on your YouTube career with that sweet and elegant name. This run was not that forgiving for me. But anyway, as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Continue suggesting those challenge runs below, and I will continue doing the ones that I deem most appropriate. But again, as always, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.